إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلوات الله وسلامه عليه أما بعد يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار ثم أما بعد يا عباد الله الحمد لله Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has allowed us to live to see these days. This is a most auspicious occasion, and this is a time wherein an individual he can gain for himself much benefit, bi'ithnillahi ta'ala. Qala fadilatul shaykh al-allama, Imam Uthaymeen rahimahullahu ta'ala, commenting about these days which are Al-Ashra, Dhul-Hijjah, the first 10 days of the month of Dhul-Hijjah. This is a very auspicious time and an occasion. فَقَالَ إِمَامَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى Al-Ashra, Dhul-Hijjah, تَبْتَدِعُ مِنْ دُخُولِ الشَّهْرِ Dhul-Hijjah. He says that the first 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah, or the 10 of Dhul-Hijjah, then they begin once the month of Dhul-Hijjah it has started. وَتَنْتَهِي بِيَوْمِ الْعِيدِ النَّحَرِ And they conclude with the day of Eid, the Eid of the slaughtering, Eid al-Adha. وَعَمَلُوا فِيهَا قَالَ فِيهِ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ And the actions that are performed therein. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said about them. And I want you to pay very close attention to this, as this is a very great time and auspicious occasion for us. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ There are no days. مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمِلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ He said, there are no days that righteous good deeds done therein are more beloved to Allah than these days. يعني العشر الأول من شهر ذي الحجة meaning the first 10 days of the month of الحجة. The Sahaba, when they heard this, that the actions done in these days are better than the actions that are done outside of these days. When the Sahaba, they heard this, قالوا يا رسول الله وَلَا الْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ They said, O Messenger of Allah, not even jihad in the way of Allah, meaning that the actions done in these days, they are better than even jihad in the way of Allah. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهِ وَسَلَّمَ So the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, وَلَا الْجِهَادِ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ خرج بنفسه وماله ولم يرجع بذلك بشيء. He said, not even jihad in the way of Allah, except for a man who goes out with his wealth. Meaning he contributed a lot of his wealth towards the effort of jihad. And he goes out with himself. Except for the man that goes out with himself, and he goes out contributing much of his wealth, or all his wealth, and he doesn't return with any of them. He doesn't return with any of them. Then this will be the only action that will trump the action during these 10 days. Hadith Sahih, رواه البخاري من حديث ابن عباس رضي الله تعالى عنهما. Therefore the Imam رحمه الله تعالى, he said, وعلى هذا فإنني أحث إخواني المسلمين على اغتنام هذه الفرصة العظيمة. He said, so with this I encourage my brothers. I encourage my brothers from the Muslims, my Muslim brothers, to take full advantage, to take full advantage of this tremendous occasion and this tremendous opportunity. وَإِنْ يَكْفِرُوا فِي عَشْرِ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ مِنَ الْأَعْمَالُ الصَّالِحَةِ. And to increase in these first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah in doing righteous good deeds. كَالْقُرَاءَةِ الْقُرْآنِ, like reading the Qur'an. وَالذِكْر بِأَنْوَاعِ, and making supplication unto Allah Ta'ala in its numerous ways, meaning all of these supplications unto Allah Azza wa Jal, to increase and making dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal during these days. And then the Imam, he brings some examples. He says, Takbeer, wa tahleel, wa tahmeed, wa tasbih. He said, like to say Allahu Akbar, like to say La ilaha illallah, like to say Alhamdulillah, like to say Subhanallah. During these days, let us have our tongues moist with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah walhamdulillah. Subhanallah. Let us have our tongues moist with the dhikr of Allah during these days. Wa sadaqah. And paying of charity. Let us strive during these days to pay as much charity as we possibly can. Let us strive during these days to increase in our payment of charity and to spend in the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. Masiyam and fasting. Let us strive during these days to fast unto Allah Azza wa Jal. And what is intended by the Ashr of the Hijjah as relates to fasting, it is as Imam bin Baz rahimahullah ta'ala he pointed out. He says that what is meant by Ashr is tis'ah. That what is meant by Ashra is tis'ah with regards to fasting. That what is intended by 10 is really 9 as relates to fasting. Meaning that we are encouraged to fast the first 9 days. And in particular, Yawm al-Arafah, which is the 9th. And as much as we possibly can from the days prior to that. From the 1st to the 9th, we are encouraged to fast as much as possible. He said, and this is what is intended, not the 10th. Because the 10th is the day of the Eid, and it's not permissible to fast on the day of the Eid. So as it relates to fasting, it's related to the first 10. Well, the first, yani, 9. That is what is meant by the 10. So the Imam, he says, وَكُلُّ أَعْمَالُ صَالِحًا. And every righteous good deeds. Every righteous good deeds. From calling to good, from forbidding evil, from helping your brothers and your sisters in that which they may need help in, from smiling in the face of your brother, so on and so forth, from giving a good word, from being righteous to one's parents, from visiting the relatives, and so on and so forth, from the righteous good deeds. Increase in doing these righteous good deeds. Imam Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, wal ajab, he said it is very amazing, and it is very strange indeed, أَنَّ النَّاسِ غَافِلُونَ عَنْ هَذِهِ الْعَشَرِ, that human beings, mankind, they are unaware of these 10. He said it's very strange that they are unaware of these 10. تَجِدَهُمْ فِي عَشْرِ رَمَضَانِ, he said you will find them in the last 10 of Ramadan. يَشْتَهِدُونَ فِي الْعَمَلِ, they're working very hard in doing actions. ولكن في العشر ذي الحجة لا تكاد تجد أحدا فرق بينها وبين غيرها. He said, but in the first 10 days of the Hijjah, he said, you will hardly find, is scarcely found, anyone who makes a distinction between them and other than them. Most people, they go about these days and they treat these days like they treat every other day of the year. You don't find them being more enthusiastic. You don't find them, if they have time to take off and days to take off, taking off some of these days so that they may increase in the worship of Allah Azza wa Jalla. You don't find that happening. The Shaykh, he says, وَإِذَا لَمْ قَامَ الْإِنسَانُ بِعَمَلُ الصَّالِحِ فِهَذِهِ أَيَّامَ الْعَشَرُ. The Shaykh, he says, وَلَكِنْ إِذَا قَامَ الْإِنسَانُ بِالْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحِ فِهَذِهِ أَيَّامُ الْعَشَرُ إحياء لما أرشد إليه النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من الأعمال الصالحة فإنه على خير عظيم. He said, but for the one who he establishes, for that person who he establishes righteous good deeds during these first 10, and he revives that guidance in which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam he pointed him to from the doing of righteous good deeds, he said, then this person, he will have come with a tremendous and outstanding amount of goodness. A tremendous amount of good. It is incumbent, ya ibad, that we take full advantage of the likes of these occasions. It is incumbent that we take advantage of our life. Period. That we take advantage of our life. And we utilize our life to gain good for ourselves after our death. We utilize the whole of our life as a preparation to meet Allah Azza wa Jal. And in particular, those times and those occasions that are auspicious. Those times and those occasions that come throughout the course of the year that are not like other days of the year. That especially and in particular, we take advantage of these days. These days, like the first 10 days of this month of Dhul-Hijjah that we are in right now. That we increase in doing righteousness. That we increase in praying voluntary prayers. That we increase in paying the voluntary charity. That we increase in fasting voluntary days. That we increase in making dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. That we increase in reading the Quran. We increase in listening to the Quran. We increase in contemplating over the Quran. That we increase in studying the Quran and reading through the tafsir of the ulama, the salaf. That we increase in studying. We increase in reading the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. We increase in singing the salat and salams upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That we increase in contemplating over the words of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That we increase in studying the meanings of the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That we take this opportunity to increase in the doing of righteous good deeds, and so we take full advantage of it. And so we will not be like the one who, as the poet he said, and I want every one of us to really contemplate on this and to look back, to examine, re-examine, and examine again our life and what it is that we are doing with it. The poet he said, إِذَا أَنْتَ لَمْ تَرُحَ الْمِزَادٍ مِنَ التُّقَى ولقيت بعد الموت من قد تزودا ندمت على أن لا تكون كمثله فترصدا للموت الذي كان أرصدا. The poet he said, if you have not gone forth with the provision of taqwa in this world, and then after your death, you met someone who adequately prepared for before his demise, then you will be regretful that you are not as the like of him. So allocate for your death just as he has allocated for his demise. If we don't prepare now, and then death comes, then that is our preparation. If we do not prepare now, and death comes, then that is our preparation, meaning we will have no preparation. So if we don't have taqwa before our death, we will not be prepared for that which comes after death. So take full advantage of these times wherein you can gather a great amount of good for yourself. These times wherein we are encouraged to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla even more so than other than these times. Take advantage of these times. Take advantage of these occasions. Don't let them pass you by. Don't live these days like you live other days, but increase in good during these days. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who increase in going and doing the righteous good deeds inside of these days. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who benefit from their lives. هذا أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فإنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Bismillah, alhamdulillah, as-salatu was-salam ala rasulillah, nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in, wa man tamassaka bi sunnatihi ila yawmiddin. Thumma amma ba'd, ya ibadullah. We want to look at one particular good deed as relates to this time that we are in. And that is the deed of making the takbir. And in particular, we're speaking about it as it comes. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illallah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Wa lillahi alhamd. We're speaking particularly about this supplication and that which is like it from the various wordings. As relates to this, Imam bin Baz rahimahullahu ta'ala, he mentions, وَأَمَّا التَّكْبِيرُ فِي أَضْحَى. And if regards to the takbir in أَضْحَى, in عِيدُ أَضْحَى, فَمَشْرُوعُ مِنْ أَوَّلِ الشَّهْرُ إِلَى نِهَايَةِ يَوْمِ الثَّالِثِ الْعَشَرُ مِنْ شَهْرِ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ. He said then, it is legislated that this takbir, the one in likes of what you just heard, then it begins from the beginning of the month. From the beginning of the month. All the way until the 13th. The 13th, and in particular or specific, Asr, on the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. That it goes from the beginning of the month all the way into the 13th. That we should be making this dua. We should be making this dhikr. Our tongue should be moist with this dhikr. And we want to highlight on this because this is something that all of us have the ability to do. Whether we are at work or we're not at work. Whether we're walking down the street, riding the bus, driving a car, we all have the ability to make this dhikr. So we should increase in it. And we should take advantage of those things which are easy for us to do. It's like fasting in the wintertime. You take advantage, as the Salafy used to say, to take advantage of the easy prey because the days are short. So you get a great reward and the days are short. So take advantage of it. So take advantage of those deeds that are easy for you to do. Take advantage. And from them is this. The Imam, he said, لِقَوْلِهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. According to Allah's statement, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَيَذْكُرُ اسْمَ اللَّهِ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. He says, so that they may bear witness to the benefit that is bestowed upon them. Whether that is from the reward that those hujjaj they get from Hajj in the Akhirah. Na'am. Or the reward that one will get from exerting themselves and doing righteous good deeds during these days that he'll see in the Akhirah. Or whether it is from a worldly gain, as the ulama tafsir they mentioned, because trade, doing business and working, is not prohibited for those who are upon Hajj. Those who are upon Hajj, they're allowed to do trade, to do work, to do make business deals. So this also is another encouragement for the Muslim to strive after that which benefits him, and a discouragement from begging and anything that will lead to begging. That even during these times, you don't have an excuse to beg. Because if you need to do some business, do some trade, do some tijara, even while doing Hajj, you're allowed to do it. You're allowed to do it. So there's no reason for you to beg. Beg for what? Do something to gain benefit from yourself. Na'am. So the reward that we will have in this world and in the hereafter. And then Allah Ta'ala, he goes on to say, what translated means, and remember the name of Allah in those fixed days. And remember the name of Allah during those fixed days. Imam bin Baz rahimahullah ta'ala, he said, here, that these particular days that are mentioned here in this ayah, wa hiya ayyamul ashr, These are the 10 days. So that the fixed days here refers to, or excuse me, the well-known days. Naam. This is a better translation. Ayyam al-ma'lumat. That the well-known days, then they refer to these 10 days. To the 10 days. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى And Allah Ta'ala, He says, وَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ And remember Allah during appointed days. And remember Allah during appointed days. Naam. And about these days, al-ma'dudat, you may say about them fixed days. During these fixed appointed days, then remember Allah Azza wa Jal. وَهِيَ أَيَّامُ التَّشْرِيقِ And these days, in particular, these are the days of Tashriq. They are the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th. The 11th, the 12th, and the 13th. So the first ayah, when it speaks about Ayyam al-Ma'lumat, then it refers to what? It refers to the 10 days. Whereas the Ayyam Ma'dudat, then it refers to Ayyam al-Tashriq. Naam? I want you to have that and to bear that in mind. It's very important, and you'll soon come to see. ولقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم and due to the statement of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم أيام التشريق أيام الأكل والشرب وذكر الله عز وجل The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said as it comes in a hadith that has been collected by Imam Muslim but the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم he said that the days of تشريق and they are the 11th, the 12th and the 13th of the Hijjah then these are days of eating and drinking so during these days we are not allowed to fast during these days During these days, we're not allowed to fast. So during this month, the 10th through the 13th, we're not allowed to fast. Because the 10th is the day of the Eid. We're not allowed to fast on the day of the Eid. And Ayyam al-Tashriq, which is the 11th, the 12th, and the 13th, we're not allowed to fast on these days. Because the Prophet ﷺ said that there are days of eating and drinking. Naam, these are days of celebrating. With dhikr Allah Azza wa Jal. And remembering Allah Azza wa Jal. And making remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Na'am. Wa dhakar al-Bukhari. And Imam Bukhari, rahimahullah ta'ala, he mentions inside of his sahih, ta'liqan. He brings inside of his sahih, na'am, ta'liqan, meaning he doesn't bring it as a hadith or enumerate it as a hadith from his collection, but he brings it, yani mu'alliqan, he brings it as a ta'liqan. Huh? The athar, As he says, عن ابن عمر وأبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنهما أنهما كانا يخرجان إلى السوق أيام العشر فيكبران ويكبر الناس بتكبيرهم أو بتكبيرهما He said that they used to go out ابن عمر and أبو هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنهما Look at this guidance from the Salaf. How they used to encourage people to do good by being examples. They used to go out to the marketplaces during these 10 days and they used to make takbir. They used to make takbir. And then the people were heard them and got reminded. So then they also started to make the takbir. They will encourage people to make the takbir during these days by going to the marketplaces and doing that. وكان عمر بن الخطاب وابنه عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنهما and عمر بن الخطاب and his son عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنهما يكبران في أيام المنى في المسجد وفي الخيمة ويرفعان أصواتهما ويرفعان أصواته أو ويرفعان أصواتهما بذلك حتى ترحج منا تكبيرا He said that they used to Umar and Abdullah ibn Umar they used to make takbir in the day of Mina doing Hajj inside of the masjid and also inside of their tents and they will raise their voices with it ويرفعان أصواتهما They will raise their voices with it. Na'am. So much so that because of them raising their voices with it, it reminded what? It reminded others also to take advantage and to make this dua, to make this dhikr into Allah Azza wa Jal. So when that happened, what happened? Is that the Muslims, because see this is how the Muslim is. When the Muslim is reminded of khair, he jumps on it. He takes the opportunity. He starts to implement it because he wants to gain good for himself and point his brothers to good. So when this started to happen and people started to be affected because the good heart is affected by good, then people in Mina, they started to be affected by it until Mina shook or equate with what? With takbir. This is how much so the Muslims start making takbir. Na'am. So we encourage, we make the takbir also to raise our voices. Not loud shouting, but to say it in that which is audible and could be heard by other than yourself. وروى عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم عن جماعة من الصحابة رضي الله تعالى عنهم التكبير في أدبار الصلوات الخمس من صلاة الفجر يوم العرفة إلى صلاة العصر من يوم الثالث عشر من ذي الحجة وذلك في حق الغير الحاج. And it has been reported, authentically reported on some of the Sahaba that they used to make this takbir after Salatul Fajr on the day of Arafah. From Salatul Fajr on the day of Arafah. So after Fajr, from the ninth, after the prayer, then they will make this takbir specifically, huh? After the prayer. All the way until the 13th, after Asr, after each prayer, they will make the takbir. And this is as relates to those who are not upon Hajj. Na'am. This is as relates to those who are not upon Hajj. Wa bihada, and with this, wa bihada, ta'lamu anna takbir al-mutlaq wa al-muqayyid yajtami'ani fi afsah aqwal al-ulama fi khamsati ayyam. He said, so therefore we see that the dhikr or the mention of this particular takbir, it comes together restrictedly and unrestrictedly in these 5 days. It comes unrestrictedly and restrictedly in these 5 days. يوم العرفة ويوم النهر وثلاثة أيام تشريق. The 5 days, meaning from the day of Arafah and on the Eid and the 3 days that follow the Eid, then they come restrictedly and unrestrictedly. Restrictedly meaning that it comes after the 5 prayers. Unrestrictedly meaning anytime during the day. So anytime during the day, then we can make the dhikr. But restrictedly during these 5-10 days, after the 5 prayers, we should be saying this dhikr. Na'am. وَأَمَّا يَوْمُ الثَّامِنِ وَمَا قَبْلَهُ إِلَىٰ أَوْلِ الشَّهْرِ فَالتَّكْبِيرِ فِيهِ مطلق لا مقيد. But as far as the 8th down, from the 1st to the 8th, then the takbir comes in it unrestrictedly. So you can make it any time during the day. Any time during the day after the five prayers, outside of that time, any time during the day. It comes unrestrictedly during these times. And he says, كما تقدم, just like it has come forward, يعني من الآيات والأثار, like we see in the آيات and the أثار. And now it points us back to those two ayat, the one that had mentioned ayam ma'lumat, that this refers to the ayam ma'lumat. It refers to the first 10 days, whereas ayam ma'dudat, it refers to the days of tashriq. So now we see the wisdom on why each time frame was mentioned. Bismillah ta'ala. Also, from those things in which we can benefit ourselves and that we are encouraged to do is the fasting of Yawm Arafah. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Suyam Yawm Arafah ahtasibu ala Allah yukaffir as-sanata allati qabla wa sanata allati ba'da. He says, then I hope for or anticipate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anticipate the reward from Allah ta'ala to expiate the sins for the one who fasts Yawm Arafah. For the one who fasts or fasts in Yawm Arafah, then I anticipate that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that He will forgive the sins of the year that is before and of the year that comes after. Na'am. وقال Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala معناه يكفر الذنوب صائمه في سنتين. Imam An-Nawawi said that this means that the sins of the person who fasted will be expiated for 2 years. Which one of us can afford to lose out on that? Nobody. 2 years. وقال والمراد بها as-sagair. And he said that that which is intended by it, that which is intended by these sins, then it means the minor sins. It means the minor sins. Because the major sins, they require tawbah. They require tawbah. Na'am, you have to make tawbah in order to be forgiven for a major sin. But as far as the minor sins, then the minor sins are wiped away by the likes of this, the likes of fasting, Yawmul Arafah. So the minor sins will be wiped away for what? For 2 years, for the one who fasts the day of Arafah. And the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, as it comes in the hadith that has been collected by Imam Muslim, يُكَفِّرُ سَنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ وَالْبَاقِيَةَ. He said that it will expiate the sins for the year of the past and of the year that remains, meaning to come. And in the year that remains, meaning to come. Ya ibadullah. We wanted to highlight these two particular deeds that are done inside of these 10 days that are particular to this time frame that we are in. Because they are deeds that the vast majority of us have the ability to do. So take advantage, ya ibad. Take advantage before it's too late. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu la tulhikum amwalukum wa la awladukum an dhikrillah wa man yaf'al dhalika fa ulaika humul khasirun. Allah ta'ala says, O you who believe, let not your property or your children divert you from the remembrance of Allah. Don't let your property, your money, your pursuit thereof, so on and so forth, nor your children divert you from the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal. Don't let that be an excuse why you don't take advantage of these days. Don't let money and your kids be an excuse why you don't take advantage of these days. Allah Ta'ala says what means, and whoever has done that, then they are the losers. Whoever has done that, then they are the losers. Allah Ta'ala, He goes on to say, وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. And pay and spend. Spend from that which we have provided you. Remember that. That which you have with you from wealth, huh? It is from that which Allah has provided you with. So Allah Ta'ala doesn't place a burden on a soul greater than it could bear. Allah doesn't place a burden on a soul except that He has given it what it needs to carry it out. Allah Ta'ala is commanding you to spend from that which He gave you. Allah Ta'ala is not telling you to go out and find something to spend from, but He's telling you to spend from that which He gave you. Before what? Min qabl. Before what? Before when? من قبل أن يأتي أحدكم الموت. Before there comes to one of you death. Before death comes to one of you. Get yourself right from now. You're still alive. Get yourself right. Don't wait. Because you may miss the opportunity, because death comes for you before that day in which you was waiting for to arrive. Get yourself right from now. Allah Ta'ala says, before there comes to one of you death. فَيَقُولَ رَبِّي لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي. And it said, oh my Lord, if you أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجْلٍ قَرِيمٍ. If you send me back for a little bit of time. Send me back for a little bit of time. This is an indication of what? It doesn't take a great deal of time for a person to try to get itself right. It don't take a great deal of time for a person to turn a situation around. So while you in the dunya and the shaitan keep telling you, not now, you need more time, you need more time, you need more time, realize the reality that the person who missed out, he'll be begging Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send him back to the dunya just for a little bit of time. Why? What he gonna do inside that little bit of time? Allah Ta'ala, He tells us. The person, he would say what? فَأَصَدَّقَ وَأَكُنْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. He said, I will give charity and I'll be from the righteous. I'll give charity and I'll do what I'm supposed to be doing. Just send me back for a little bit of time and I'll do what's right. I'll spin in your way. I'll give charity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ends off this chapter of the Quran by saying, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجْلُهَا. And Allah does not send anybody back after their death has come. Allah does not send anybody back after their appointed time has come, meaning after their death comes. You're not going back. It's too late. Wallahu khabirun bima ta'malun. And Allah is well aware of what you do. Allah is well aware of what you do. Ya ibadallah, if it's going to be a time for you to try to get your life together, then it's doing these 10 days, which are the best 10 days of the year. These are the best 10 days of the year. And as Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, because somebody may say, well, what about the last 10 days of Ramadan? Then as Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, he mentioned, he said, those are the best 10 nights of the year. But these days that we are in are the best 10 days of the year. So if there's any time that you want to get yourself right, now is the time to do it. Don't wait. Do it from right now. Do it from right now. Do it from right now. Before death comes to you and it's too late. Aqimu salah.